All right, so here's a quick demo of how to pull in log messages directly from Cisco ISE. Now, this actually relies on Cisco ISE having a log target configured to send syslog traffic over to the XSOAR server. So in this instance, I'm going to configure a new instance of our Syslog Listener. I'm just going to call it Cisco ISE, and in this case, I'm just going to map it to a demo incident type that doesn't have a playbook associated with it, and then I'm going to use a custom mapper that I created for the syslog messages themselves. Since I've already got a rule configured in my firewall, I'm going to configure it to run on port 1337. I'll save that. Now I'll go over to Cisco ISE and I'm going to add a remote logging target, just calling it XSOAR. And it's going to be TCP since our integration does not support UDP-based listening. Put in the information that I need here. Hit submit. That is now configured. And I'm going to go over to my logging categories. And just for testing, since I don't have any endpoints configured here, nor do I have an 802.1x policy configured, I'm just going to do the AAA audit logs. I'll add those. I'll add XSOAR to that. And then I'll do the diagnostics as well. Hit save. Now those are configured, and we've got a listener going on here. And as you can see, we've already started to get message traffic in. Now, with the integration, you can configure a regular expression to filter out the specific messages you're looking for. So if you're looking for authc.1x failures, you can filter those here and have that automatically creating an incident within XSOAR, thus bypassing the need for the SIM as part of the demo. For the mapper, it's relatively straightforward. I'm looking at my incoming mapper, I'll show all the map fields. I just basically took the name and I assigned it to the message, the incoming message. Here's your host name. And then same thing with the app message. So when we go back into one of those incidents, you can also see that information's broken out already into the investigation data. So this just provides a simple way to listen for log messages from Cisco ISE and then filter it based on whatever criteria you're looking for. Hope this helps.